Hello everyone and welcome to another Affinity Designer tutorial using the contour tool in conjunction with custom shapes, developing a drop cap typographical idea for your own projects. Up next. So inside Affinity Designer with a new document open, I have already created the number 2 text layer. Now, I did spend a bit of time searching for a font that will give me some thick areas around its contour. The font's name is Engravers MT, and it's a free font from Microsoft. Great. So, I've got that text layer. I will tap on the Edit menu, and then I will duplicate this just in case I need to go back to the original. With this text layer here, I will tap on the Edit menu again, and I will convert this to curves. Great. Now, what I'm going to do is, you see, we have now the foundation of the shape. I will go ahead and customize this even further in order to improve the overall contour. So for that, let's see, I'm going to tap on the node tool. And I will tap on that node, and at the bottom of the context toolbar, I will tap on the trash icon to delete that. I will do the same for this node. Select that node and just bring out this control handle to continue the curve. So we have a nice flow to it. Tap on that, just bring up the thickness a bit. See that? Then I will select this again with the node tool and marquee select all of these nodes. Tap to remove them. Tap on that node. Going to bring this in, like so. Okay, then I will switch to the ellipse tool, create an ellipse, let's give it a color, of course, a fill color black, and I'm going to move this into place. Now you have to be a little careful here, so this looks natural, that it's flowing naturally. All right, something along those lines. This is not perfect yet. All right, so I've got that. Again, you just have to spend a little time here to make it perfect. And another thing I'm going to do is tap on this node right here. I'm going to remove that. Tap on that node and just bring it outside a bit to create a bit of more thickness. So if you like what you see, which in this case I do, I will markedly select this too, because I want this to be just one shape. So back on the Edit menu, I will use one of the Boolean operations under the geometry, and that will be the add Boolean operation. And as you can see now, we have the shape that I was going for, and we are ready to go to the next step, which that will be the working with the contour tool. All right, moving right along, I did spend a bit of time adjusting nodes and control handles, making sure that the curved shape is smooth enough. So in this case, I like what I see. I would apply a fill color. Then I would tap on the Edit menu and I'll create a duplicate. And for that, I'm going to use this fill color. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to grab the contour tool to offset the stroke of the shape, which will offset its boundaries. And we will do that by increasing or decreasing the radius amount. So I would tap to grab the contour tool, and at the bottom of the context toolbar, all I'm going to do is just decrease the point radius. And I'm looking here interactively at the end results, something along those lines. Great. Now I'm going to actually bake the appearance of this newly contoured object and convert this to curves. And then at the bottom of the context toolbar, I'm just going to tap on the bake appearance. And now this has been converted to curves, which means I will switch to the node tool and I will tap on this node and these nodes here to basically remove them, because it would be easier for me to create just a perfect circle instead of trying to, you know, move these nodes around to create just a perfect ellipse. So I'm just going to create a perfect circle, move it into place, and just bring it around the center. All right, something along those lines. Okay, What's next? Well, let's go ahead and select this one here, this area. I will tap to remove this node, tap to remove this node as well. I will select this node and pull out the handle, the control handle, and just bring this node down a bit to continue this nice curved shape. All right. So I like what I see. Again, I will create another duplicate of this curve. So tap on the edit menu, create a duplicate. Let's give it another fill color here. And then again, I will grab the contour tool and I'm going to offset again the radius here. And I'm going to bring this down like so. I like what I see. In this case, I will convert this into curves by tapping on the bake appearance like so. So for this next step, I will create custom curves and shapes that will give me the illusion of a 3D lettering. So for that, I will grab the ellipse tool and I'm just going to create just an ellipse here. I will rotate this a bit and just create the general shape. So this is one thing. Another thing is to tap on the edit menu. We're going to convert this to curves. Then I will switch the node tool, tap on this curve, and then at the bottom of the context toolbar, I will go ahead and tap on the break command. So I can just tap on that and remove this node and remove that node. And now I'm left with this curve here. I know it's not perfect, but we're going to get it. We're going to improve on that. That's one thing. Another thing is inside the Stroke Studio and looking at the pressure input box, I will create a custom pressure profile. Now, in order to form this, first I'm going is I will drag this end node downwards and I will drag this end node also downwards. As you can see, everything disappears, of course. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click halfway along the profile line to create, to add a node here, which I'm going to bring upwards to taper the stroke according to the curvature of the graph. And we'll be able to see that better if we increase the width here. See that? Okay, this is not perfect yet. So I will tap on the layer studio and I will tap and bring this at the bottom of the layer stack. I will switch to the node tool. Just bring this in here and just basically do just a little better job with this curve. All right. This is not a very good curve yet, but it's getting there. All right. Just have to spend a little time here. All right. So let's not waste the time. I will spend a little time on my own to improve it. I just want to show you how to create those curves here. Now I will switch to the pen tool. I'm going to create the second curve here. Then I'll go all the way down there. Switch to the node tool. Bring this close. Try to have the same contour of like the other shape that I look here, and then increase the width of the stroke to have some more thickness. I will tap on the layers menu, on the layers studio, tap and bring this at the bottom of the layer stack. With the node tool, just going to refine this more and more and more till I get to the curve that I wish to have. So something along those lines. I'm not very happy here yet because you have to make sure that this flows nicely. All right. Again, I'll spend a little time to refine this on my own. But one more thing I want to do is I will tap on that, create a duplicate, increase the size of the circle here, and then I would tap and hold and bring this at the bottom of the layer stack as well, and create that. So for this last step, I will go ahead and create a bunch of straight segments, and I will clip them inside the thick areas of these contour objects, contour shapes. So I will grab the rectangle tool and I'm just going to create just a rectangle here. And I'm looking at our thickness around 5, let's say, not too much. I will switch to the move tool And I'm going to create a bunch of duplicates here. All right, and don't worry about the placement of that yet. What matters right now is we have the thickness, we have a lot of them around. All right, so inside the Layer Studio, I will select all of these rectangular shapes. All right, and then inside the Transform Studio and inside the alignment options, first I will align them horizontally to the left or right. So I will tap on the align right. And then inside the align vertically, I will go ahead and tap on this space vertically. And all of these have been aligned perfectly fine. Great. Which means back on the Layer Studio, I would tap on the edit menu to group them, first of all. And then I would tap and hold and clip these lines, this group, inside this curved shape. Great. I like what I see. Now, I'm going to add a bit of an effect here. So I would tap on the layer effects, and I would toggle on the visibility of the bevel and emboss. Then I would tap on the bevel emboss, and at the bottom of the context toolbar, we do have some options. In this case, for the type, I'm going to choose emboss. And all I'm going to do is increase the pixel radius here. All right, I like what I see, so I will switch to the move tool. Just going to move this here so it covers everything. You can also stretch that out a bit. Doesn't matter. These are straight lines. All right. I like what I see. And I will do the same, of course, for the rest of the shape here. There's one more thing I would like to mention is that I will tap on this curve and I will tap to have just a bit of a stroke color here, just like a bit of a stroke. And the color is white and the width is like 2.3. What I'm looking for is just a breathing space so I can see the difference between all of these curves. I would like to thank each one of you for visiting my channel, watching the inspiring lectures and project tutorials. Do not forget to subscribe and share the knowledge.